Good day, students. I hope you all are staying safe during this pandemic COVID-19. I am Murugan Thiyarajan, working in Meemu Atoll Education Center. In today's computer science class, we will be discussing about binary systems and its uses in the computers. We will be seeing the uses of binary numbers in computer systems and to convert deanery integers to binary and binary integers to deanery, and the concept of byte and how and what way we can measure the amount of information that can be stored in a storage device. And finally, we will be seeing the uses of computer registers for the given applications. I will be happy if I am able to use the information, whatever I have learned, and express the uses of binary numbers in computer systems and convert the deanery integers to binary and binary integers to deanery. Then express the concept of byte and able to measure the amount of information that I can store in my storage devices, pen drive or hard disk drive. Then the uses of computer registers for the given applications. Binary number system. So when we discuss about binary number system, at first we should remember that computer is an electronic device. So computer is a device which works with the electricity. So before going into binary number system, we should remember that computer doesn't understand the informations what we give as it is, because we are communicating with the computer with a high level language and the computer can understand only machine language. So you will be hearing this machine language, and when I say the computer can understand only machine language, means you will be having a interest to know what is machine language. So machine is also having a language. So machine language is binary numbers. Okay, so binary numbers means the computer is storing the information in the form of signals, that is electric signal, that is on or off, that is represented with the binary number system 0 or 1. So the binary number system is having only two digits in it, that is 0 or 1. 0 represents off state and 1 represents on state. So that is the reason why here in this lesson we are going to discuss on binary number system. So that is the importance of binary. So binary is a base 2 number system. Okay, so this system is chosen as it has only two digits, 1 and 0 only. Here we have to know about processor, and you know processor is the brain of the computer. So the processor is the one which is processing the instructions and the data or the values what we give into the computer. So we should know how and what way the processor is able to process it. The processor is having millions of transistors in it which act as the switches. So switches means usually it will be having only two state, on or off. So on is represented by the binary digit 1 and off is represented by the binary digit 0. So again I have to say that computer doesn't know the value 0 or 1. For our convenient only, we are using these two 0 or 1s by which the information is stored in the computer. So the processor is processing the instructions that is given by the program what we are working with, and based upon that it is producing and giving us the result. Okay, so the binary number system is a very important number system in which it is able to communicate to the devices, that is the hardware devices, and that is the way how it is doing the processing. So whatever the information that is stored in the computer has to be first of all translated or converted to the binary number system, only then the computer will be able to process it. Then here in this lesson we are also going to see about deanery or decimal number system, which is having only digits 0 to 9, and as it is having 10 digits 0 to 9, it is having the base 10 number system. Okay, it is a base 10 number system. Now we are going to see the difference between deanery and binary number system. At first we will see what is deanery. So as I said before, deanery is having the digits 0 to 9, and so when it is set as base 10, it is having the base 10 value. Okay, the unit it uses increases by the powers of 10, that is 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, like that it goes on. So whenever we are going to write the deanery number system, so we have to start it from the right hand side, and as I said before, it raises to the power of 10. So starting, it raises 10 to the power 0, that it gives the value 1. So 10 to the power 0 value is 1, 10 to the power 1 value is 10, 10 to the power 2 value is 100. So likewise it goes on towards the left. Binary. So binary, as I said before, binary is a number of only 0 and 1, that is only 2 digit it has, and so only it is set as base 2 number system. The units it uses increases by the power of 2, that is 2 to the power 0, 1, 2 to the power 1, 2, like that it goes on. So 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 512, so like that it goes on. So whenever we write either deanery or binary, we have to write it from the right hand side. Okay, so the power starts from the right hand side, to the power 0, then to the power 1, to the power 2. Okay, so that is how the value gets incremented. Okay, so deanery number system increments with the multiples of 10, binary number system increases with the multiples of 2, which you should remember at this point of time. Now we are going to see how and what way to convert the given positive deanery integer into binary. So at first, before seeing that, we should remember that we are going to convert the given deanery into 8-bit binary. So here binary is to be converted. You see, deanery is to be converted to binary. So we should have the binary boxes. That is, binary boxes, in the sense, why I say boxes means here we are converting it into 8-bit binary. So you should have 8 boxes, and in that 8 boxes we are going to write the binaries multiples of 2, that is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. So why we are writing so? Because only with this table we will be able to easily convert the given deanery number into binary, and here we are going to do it with the method 1, that is continuous subtraction method. Okay, so in this continuous subtraction method 1, we are going to convert the given deanery number into 8-bit binary. So the deanery number given over here is 155, which has to be converted into 8-bit binary. So we are going to convert the 155, isn't it? So what we have to do is we have to compare the given 155 value with the value which is there at the firstmost left hand side. Okay, that is 128, that is there in the firstmost left hand side. So we are going to compare in step 1 the given deanery value 155 with 128. What we have to see? We have to see whether the given value 155 is greater than or equal to 128, and definitely the 155 is greater than 128. So we have to put a 1 in the box below 128. Okay, then after that we have to deduct that 128 from 155. So we will get a remainder of 27. So this 27 has to be taken to step 2 to compare with the value 64. So when we compare the value 27, whether it is greater than or equal to 64, we know it is not greater than or equal to 64. So now what we have to do? We have to put a 0 in the box below 64. Then we are again comparing the value 27 with 32. So 27 is not greater than or equal to 32. So here again we have to put a 0 below the box. Okay, that is below 32 we have to put 0. Now we are comparing 27 and we see whether it is greater than or equal to 16. Yes, it is greater than 16. So we have to put a 1 below 16 and then deduct 16 from 27. So we will get a remainder 11. So in the next step we are going to compare the remainder 11 with 8. So when we compare the value 11 with 8, 11 is greater than 8. So again we have to put a 1 below the 8. Okay, and we have to deduct 8 from 11, where we get a remainder of 3. So now when we compare 3 with 4, 3 is not greater than 4 or equal to, isn't it? So we have to put a 0 below the box 4. Then now we are comparing the value 3 with 2. So 3 is greater than 2. So we are putting a 1 below 2 and then deduct 2 from 3, where we get a remainder of 1. So now when we compare 1 with the given 1, it is equal to. So we have to put a 1 below the box where the value is having 1. So now we have converted the given DNA number into 8-bit binary. So in the top box we are having the multiples of 2, that is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, and in the below box we are having the converted binary number. Okay, so the conversion says that DNA number 155, after converting into 8-bit binary, we got 100 11 011. Okay, so if you want to cross check, what we can do, we have to check it out though. So how to check? So to check it out, what we have to do is we have to take the binary numbers, that is the powers of 2 binary numbers, and add up wherever 1s are there. So we have 128, 16, 8, 2 and as well as 1. So when we add up all these things, we will get 155. So that is how we can compare and check whether the work has been done correctly or not. And one more thing what you have to remember is, by using this 8-bit binary number system, we can convert the highest value of DNA number is 255. So beyond 255, if you have a DNA value and if you want to convert it to binary, we have to use another system, that is 12-bit binary, or if not 16-bit binary. So only then we will be able to convert, and there is no limitation. We can convert any highest value of DNA number into a binary number. So once again I remember you that whatever the values we store in the computer, or whatever the information we store in the computer, before processing, the computer will convert those informations into binary, and only then it can be processed by the computer, because the computer understands only machine language. So this is method 2 for converting the given DNA number into binary. So this is a successive division method. This is a successive division method where we have to divide the given DNA number by the base value of binary, that is 2. So whenever we divide, we will get a remainder. So that remainder we have to write it on the right hand side. So when we divide 155 by 2, we will get the quotient 7 and remainder is 1. The next, again we are going to divide the 77 by 2, so we will get the quotient 38, remainder 1. So likewise we have to go on, proceed further, till we get the 0. Then after that, what we have to do is the remainders has to be written from bottom to top, then we will get the binary number. So this is another method to convert the given DNA number into binary. So it can be done by using the successive division method. Students, you can test yourself. Okay, so for that what you have to do is you have to turn to page number 4 in your textbook, where you can see the test yourself to convert the DNA numbers into binary. So you please try. Now we will see how to convert the binary integers into DNA. So here we are going to convert a 8-bit binary number into DNA. So for that what we have to do is the same method. We have to draw a table which is having 8 boxes. Okay, so it will be having 2 rows. First row will be having the binary numbers, that is powers of binary, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, and the below box we are going to write the given binary number that has to be converted. Then what we have to do is we have to add up the values wherever ones are there. That is, the equivalent DNA numbers for each non-zero bit has to be added up. And we see here 128 is having 1 in it, 32 is having 1 in it, 8 is having 1 in it, and as well as 2 and 1. So we are going to sum up all these values: 128 plus 32 plus 8 plus 2 plus 1. So we will get a total of 171. So 171 is the DNA number for the given binary. Okay, so this is how we are going to convert the binary integers into DNA. And here on the screen, it shows how to convert a 12-bit binary number into DNA. Okay, so 12-bit binary means it will be having 12 boxes. So how these 12 boxes comes? It is multiples of 2. So in the previous 8 boxes, it had the highest value 128, isn't it? So now 128 multiplied by 2, we will get 256. 256 multiplied by 2, we will get 512. So like that, we will be getting the highest value 2048. Okay, so this is a 12-bit binary number conversion method. So what binary numbers has to be converted has to be written in the below boxes and add up the non-zero bit values. So 2048 plus 512 plus 128 plus 32 plus 8 plus 2 plus 1. When we add up all these values, we will get a total of 2731. So that is the DNA number. So the equivalent DNA number for this 12-bit binary is 2731. Students, you can test yourself by turning to page number 5 in your textbook and convert the given binary numbers into DNA. I hope in this lesson you will be learning and learned how to convert the binary numbers to DNA and as well as DNA numbers to binary. Byte. What is byte? So byte is the unit of data which is having 8 bits in it. Bits means it is having either 0 or 1. So again, in the bracket it is given as binary digits. So how the bits came? So the first two letters of binary, BI, and the last two letters of digits, TS, are taken together and it gets bits. So binary digits. So it says the digits are used, 0 or 1 are used for to store the information in the computer, and so only the computer set as a digital storage device. Okay, 0 or 1 is the values used over there. So 0 represents off and 1 represents on. Okay, so the byte is the smallest unit of memory in a computer. A byte can be used to represent a character. For example, it can be a letter, a number, or a symbol. So byte is the smallest unit of memory. Okay, so we will be seeing how and what way we can use the byte to measure the amount of information that can be stored in a storage device. So here in the screen you are seeing a table. Okay, so it is having 3 columns in it: unit of measurement, abbreviation, and as well as conversion. Okay, so the storage devices are used for to store the information in the computer. So it can be documents, it can be audio files, video files. Okay, so before storing any information in the computer, we should know how much amount of information we can store it in a computer. And like the same now, in this COVID-19 situation, most of us are depending upon the mobile data. So only with the mobile data we are able to browse the internet. So we may afford 6 GB of data or 10 GB of data. So when we are using this amount of data, we should know the consumption. The consumption can be known only if you have a measurement. Okay, so for that measurement we need this information, so we can calculate how much amount of data can be downloaded with the data package what we have afforded. When we are downloading a movie, a picture, okay, that is a movie. When we download the movie, we should know what amount of data is left in our package. So after calculation only we can decide whether we can download it or not. Okay, so we will see here bit. What is bit? So bit is a binary digit. It is either 0 or 1. And 4 bits is 4 different combinations, isn't it, of zeros or ones. So that is said as a nibble. So a nibble will be having 4 bits in it. So 4 bits is used to represent a hexadecimal that we are going to discuss in the next topic, hexadecimal. Okay. Then 8 bits is equal to 1 byte. And 1024 bytes is equal to 1 kilobyte. 1024 kilobytes is equal to 1 megabyte. And the highest amount of storage is petabyte, which is 1024 terabyte. And here you can see in kilobyte it has been given 2 to the power of 10. Okay. Megabyte 2 to the power of 20. That is multiples of 2. If you put 2 into 2 into 10 times and multiply, you will get 1024. So here the binary is the main important thing used in the measurement. Okay, so you should remember this measurement table whenever you want to measure the amount of information that can be stored in a storage device. Registers. So computer register. So when we go to the library to take a book, our information is recorded in a book, and that book is called as a register. So like the saying, in the computer registers are used for to store small piece of information. So why is small piece of information is stored? We have already discussed that processor is a component which is called as the brain of the computer, which is processing all the instructions and as well as the data or the value what we giving. Okay, so the information or the instructions or the values has to be stored, which can be easily accessed by the processor for processing, and it should be in a high speed, isn't it? So only then the processing will be faster. So that's why we are using the register. So register is a small piece of high speed memory which holds values and instructions for processing. And there are two types of register. One is processor registers and hardware registers. So processor registers are program counter, the accumulator, and the memory address register. So program counter will count the next instruction. Okay, so it will assign a value for to proceed with the next instruction. Accumulator is there, and as well as the memory address register is also there, which is used in the processor registers. And then comes the hardware registers. So hardware registers are specific to different types of hardware devices, such as robot arm, the digital instrument, and the counting systems. So robot arm will be having registers which can be used for to pass out the value for to control the robot arm. The robot arm has to be lifted up, brought down, and as well as moved to the left or to the right, and to pick an object, and as well as to place an object. So for that we have to give the instructions. The instructions given to the robot arm will be stored in its registers before processing. Students, we have come to the end of the lesson. I hope this lesson was very interesting and you have learned about binary system, and now you will be having the information to convert the given denary number into binary and the given binary number into denary, and what is byte, how and what way we can measure the amount of information that can be stored in a storage device. Okay, students, thank you. Stay home and stay safe.